Welcome to episode 6. This video covers lighting your level. One of the easiest ways to vastly improve the quality of your levels is by well-placed lighting. You can transform a badly lit room into a piece of art. Let's take a look at a before and after example. Here is the first campaign level without any lighting. Doesn't look too bad at all. But let's turn on the lights, and it's a world of difference. Let's take a look at the lighting options available to us. Jump into prop mode. We can adjust the global ambient lighting via the light controller prop. All default levels start with one of these. If you enter the prop properties, you'll see options for ambient lighting, contrast, saturation, and the ability to apply a filter. This prop affects the default lighting across the entire level. So if you want a dark, scary level, then set the brightness down low and apply the terror filter. Or if you want a bright level, set the filter strength back down to 0 and raise the global ambient and ambient lift. It's a great first stop for setting the atmosphere. Next, the actual light props. Open up the catalogue and look at the categories. You'll see lighting appears under furniture and circuits. Circuit lighting only shows the lights that you can connect to in circuit mode, while furniture lights include all of the light props. First, I want to brighten up the entire stage, so I'll add 2 square lights on the top. Let's adjust these by entering the prop properties. On this side, I'll change the colour to an orange glow and increase the intensity. We also have options for the range, which is how far the light reaches, and an option for the indirect intensity. The best way to visualise indirect intensity is to consider a torch. The main beam of light you see is the direct brightness, but as light reflects off of surfaces and bounces around, it also brightens up the area outside of that direct beam. This is the indirect intensity. We also have the option to turn shadows on and off. Although shadows make the level look better, they have a big performance cost, so placing a lot in close proximity isn't the best idea. You'll also notice that in prop mode, there are 2 limitations for shadow and non-shadow casting lights. Next, I'll add some wall-mounted lights to shine down on my subject. Again, I'll edit their prop properties, change the colours to purple and green respectively, bring up the intensity and increase the range. I still feel that we can add more impact to this scene. I want my friend's shadow to be more prominent. So I'll add cylindrical light just in front of them. Let's also look at the circuit lights. As you can probably imagine, circuit lights need power before they turn on. I placed some along the top there earlier. I'll open up the prop properties window and show you that they have different options than the lights before. We no longer have any of the intensity or indirect intensity settings, but only the colour and range. But with the help of an oscillator and a sequence selector, I can make a pretty awesome light show like this. Lights really are both fun and powerful, so play around with them and see what you can achieve.